theatrics, singing, and music, all things you can experience by going to an opera.
And this week in the Artist Studio, Molly Cooney found out what made one Des Moines man fall completely in love with opera.
He says he was bitten by the bug, the opera bug, while he was in college. And 20 years later, Mike Egel is now the general and artistic director for the Des Moines Metro Opera here in Indianola. 20 years, what brought you to this point, Mike?
Well, I often say that when I grew up, I never intended to be involved in opera. I grew up in Algona, Iowa, in the northern part of the state, in a fairly agricultural community, and never had any intention of being involved in opera. I guess I always loved music. I always liked all kinds of music. I grew up with listening to country music and rock and things like that, and became interested in musical theater. Came to college at Simpson College, which is well known for its undergraduate program in opera. I actually told myself before I got here to Simpson as a student that I was not going to get involved in that opera stuff, no matter what happened at Simpson. But as soon as I started hearing my friends singing opera and getting used to the music, I realized it's just great music. It's just great storytelling, great music, and fell in love with it. And here I am 20 years later at the head of the company.
You have worked from internship on up. How have you seen the company change in the past 20 years?
I think we've continued to focus on our mission, which is to provide a stage for rapidly rising professional trained American talent. And we've, in the last 5 years, I think really committed to that even more so. I think our business has changed. The business of opera has changed dramatically over the last 4 or 5 years, actually maybe even the last 10 years. There's been an extraordinary emphasis on storytelling, on making sure that the dramatic elements of opera, the theatrical elements of opera, match the great music. And that's, I think, we live in a multimedia visual age, and opera has done a lot of catching up to that over the last 10 years. It is, I think, the original multimedia art form from the very beginning. It was conceived of as a way to bring together all of the art forms, visual art, storytelling, costuming, singing, orchestral playing, all of these things in one art form, in one evening, in one sitting. And it still does that, and I don't think there's anything that's been created since that does that quite as well.
The singers that you attract and bring in, where are they from? How do you get them?
Well, it's we spend a lot of time looking all over the nation for opera singers. Every fall, I spend a good deal of time in New York and Chicago and in various other cities identifying talent. I spend time watching national opera competitions. As I mentioned before, our mission calls us to be a stage for rapidly rising professional American-trained opera talent. And we spend a lot of time looking for the great singers that are up and coming, winning competitions, major competitions, coming to attention in the national opera industry, and then bringing them to Iowa to make their debut here in important roles and getting their professional experience here. We've been very good at that. That's something that people have noticed. I think that's one of the reasons why people come from so far to see our productions here, because they know they're seeing the stars of tomorrow here in Iowa. We also have a number of people that are Iowa-raised and trained singers that are part of both the main stage season, typically, and also as part of our apprentice artist program.
What would you say to a first-time opera goer? Maybe a little hesitant. It's not really what I'm into. What would you say?
I would say, come give it a chance. If you like great music and you like great stories, you're going to love opera. For me, the thing that has always been that I've considered remarkable is every opera has great music. It's all great storytelling. Everyone is different from the one before. I have yet to encounter one that's like the one I saw the night before. Each opera is specific and very different and very detailed. If you're at all unsure of which opera to attend, you can certainly call our box office. Let our box office folks know of what your particular taste is, the kind of stories you like, and we can help get you to the opera that might best match your kind of interest.
And maybe the bug will bite them too.
That's right.
Mike, thank you, and here's to another 20 years of great success.
Thank you.
For KCCI, I'm Molly Cooney in the Artist Studio.